Welcome back to the channel, everybody. My name is Artie with CoinCasso, and in this video, we go over the top news articles written over the weekend so that you guys can stay up to date and informed on everything going around in the cryptocurrency world. In the last 24 hours, Bitcoin dropped nearly 5%, $400 down below that $9,000 threshold. Let's jump into the news and find out exactly what's going on. This first article is titled Bitcoin Price Drops to 8,840. Key metrics signal BTC may correct further. As the weekly close approaches, Bitcoin's price dropped out of the ascending channels to 8,840, marking six consecutive lower highs since June 2019. Within the last hour, Bitcoin price dropped to 8,840. The drop came with less than 8 hours left to the weekly close. A confluence of miners selling more Bitcoin than they mine, Bitcoin recording six consecutive lower highs, and the retest of 8,800 support level leaves BTC vulnerable to a severe pullback. Six consecutive lower highs since June 19th, Bitcoin has recorded six consecutive lower highs. The price rejected at 14,000, 13,300, 12,300, 10,600, 10,500, and 10,000, making every local top lower than the previous peak. In technical analysis, lower highs indicate the buyers are failing to establish a new bull cycle. Every time a lower peak is reached, it shows the selling pressure in the market is simply too strong to break out of it. A clear rejection of the $9,800 to $9,900 range and the projected third test of the 8,800 support level suggests Bitcoin is not ready to initiate a rally above 10,000 just yet. The price of Bitcoin rebounded to 8,840, testing the 8,800 support area for the second time within 4 days. Typically, the digital asset tends to break down below a heavy level of support in the third or fourth touch. This means BTC is likely to see a clean breach of 8,800 upon the weekly close. Almost immediately after dropping close to 8,800, the price of Bitcoin rebounded to around 8,900, showing Bitcoin is set for a short-term price spike following the weekly opening on May 25th. But data from TradingLight shared by cryptocurrency trader Hisaka shows a significant amount of sell orders on OKX in the $9,300 to $9,400 range. When I was doing my price analysis last week, I was discussing that $9,200 range, and if we maintain an upwards trajectory, we should see a nice bull run out of it. But if we fell below it, we should tank to about that $7,500, $7,900 mark. So for those of you that invested in the $9,000 range, we're going to have to wait a few weeks before it even gets back to that point, if it ever does. As for right now, definitely do not panic sell, because then you're going to capture those losses instead of just waiting out the storm. And on to our next article of the day, which is titled RenBTC quietly goes live in latest bid to bring Bitcoin to Ethereum. The latest implementation of Bitcoin on the Ethereum blockchain quietly went live this week. There are 1.24 RenBTC live on the Ethereum mainnet now. Three sources with knowledge of the project had confirmed that this Ren smart contract live ahead of its launch announcement. However, there's no way yet for the members of the public to mint additional RenBTC. While the smart contracts have been deployed on Ethereum, RenVM itself is not actually on the mainnet. This is because RenVM is a distinct network separate to Ethereum. The RenVM is a way to hold a cryptocurrency in a multi-signature wallet controlled by nodes in the RenVM and mint a representation of the asset as an ERC-20 token for use on Ethereum. Unlike other projects, RenVM is bringing more than Bitcoin to Ethereum. To sum this up, RenBTC is like Bitcoin on the Ethereum network. So it would be like US dollars and Tether. I heard about this recently, and I'm really curious to see if this is actually going to pan out, because in my opinion, the Ethereum network is far superior to the Bitcoin network. That's why I've been moving some of my assets from Bitcoin to Ethereum, because with Ethereum 2.0 coming out, predicted at the end of July, we should see a nice upswing in the price of Ether. And onto our last article of the day, which is titled Bitcoin's Price: Why Today's Weekly Close is Crucial to Avoid 8,000s. Bitcoin's price needs to secure a weekly close above 9,300 to avoid dropping below the ascending channel to revisit lows below 8,800. As mentioned in a previous analysis, Bitcoin price continues to bounce off the ascending channel trend line, but sustaining above the 20-day moving average remains a challenge. On the 4-hour chart, we can see the Bollinger Bands tightened within the last hour and the price pushed above the 20-day moving average on a low volume move. The upper Bollinger Band is currently located at 9,449, just a few dollars away from 9,500, which has a severe and important support and resistance zone. Currently, the RSI is rising towards 50, and the MACD has pulled above the signal line. If such a move occurs, the retest of the range high between 9,800 and 10,100 is likely as the last step. As this level has been tested many times already, the resistance level should be weaker as a rule. For the time being, investors are looking for a weekly close above 9,300, or a retest of lows in the $8,800 to $8,500 range is expected. In the event that Bitcoin loses the $8,550 support, there is a risk of the price dropping to a wider range from $8,200 to $7,400. Now, I know a lot of you guys are freaking out, like, oh my God, what do? I bought Bitcoin at $9,500. I'm down $1,000. Should I sell? Should I hold on? Basically, what we're seeing here is quite a large correction. We were down at $3,800, and we've been on a crazy bull run ever since. So it's expected to see a small correction. It definitely won't drop back down to that $4,000 range, but it's going to go up and it's going to come down and it's going to go up. But overall, if you long-term hold, you should see a nice steady gain. This is why it's very stressful for people that day trade Bitcoin. They see these huge price fluctuations as opposed to checking Bitcoin once a week to see how it's doing, making sure your positions are good, making sure it didn't drop to 4,000. Because if it did, you know, you buy back in, you dilute the price that you bought it at before. Overall, you need to think about the long term. If people are already comparing Bitcoin to an asset like gold, you know that it's going to be worth something in the future. You may not see the returns now or even in the next 6 months, but if you hold on to it for 4, 5, maybe 6 years, you should see a massive, massive gain. And then you won't even worry about these small little dips of a few hundred dollars. My opinion personally, I would wait a little bit more, because if we do fall below that point, we should see that $7,500 range come in. And at that point, I'm definitely a buyer. And if you guys are interested in buying any cryptocurrencies, head on over to CoinCasso.com, register for a free account today, and start trading on that platform. But that's it for the news, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you got some value out of it. Please don't forget to like the Facebook page, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and join us again tomorrow when we go over the top prices and the news.